tried to do is to help jewelers avoid some of the common mistakes that people make when they're developing their web presence. Just going through this checklist of about 20 things or so, I hope that they'll be able to go back and either improve their websites or develop a new one without falling into these traps. Well, I think the first mistake they make is not owning their own website. A lot of people use outside firms to do it, and they don't realize that that firm actually owns the website. Another big thing is they allow the site to be created without it being easily changed. So we always tell people to make sure that they have a CMS, or content management system, that allows you to change anything on your website without having to hire somebody or pay them to do it. The third thing that people do is they allow the site to be programmed in languages that are expensive or cumbersome, and they're not open source, that therefore everyone knows how to program them, and so it's easy to find people who can change your site for you, can make major revisions. You're not locked into paying licensing fees and royalties over and over again. The importance of a Facebook page to a company is now more important than their website. If you can convince someone to become a follower or a fan of your company on Facebook, then they're going to be getting updates from you on a regular basis in a medium that they're interacting with every day. We advise jewelers to spend as much or more time on their social media presence than they do on their website. Keep the website to just the basic information so that people can find your phone number, find your hours, find your directions to get to your store.